Welcome back to Shadow Hearts Covenant, almost called it the wrong game. Let's go back to Wales. Because we need to recover a book, so that we can rent... Roger, you had a mailbox installed. I mean, it kind of stinks because the owner's not around, but you know. Joachim? That's Roger's mailbox. Joachim? You're gonna take it, aren't you? Joachim? Oh no. You're taking it, aren't you? Oh boy. Yeah! Especially since that's technically the property of, you know, the post office, but... Oh, boy. Yeah, weren't you supposed to be the hero? Why are you stealing? Apparently, Joachim does not care about theft. Okay. Now, let's actually go to you. Stuffed full of letters. So, Roger is never getting the mail that he deserves. Poor guy. There is a new treasure chest in here, it just kind of appeared, but this one is rather important that we collect it, otherwise we won't be able to progress. Rope ladder! Because if you remember, there was an entrance where we started in here. That's... yeah, we kind of need that. And the vending machine's actually working now. And again, we can use the judgment ring to, you know, save money, which is kind of a little bit odd, but, you know. Do we have... we do... new equipment. We're not going to buy it for Geppetto, since I'm not you. Oh, I can't afford everything. That's bad. Can I... Okay, we can sell that, sell that, sell that. I get rid of the leather caps, why not? Sure. How much is that? $24.69 with a markup? Probably going... You know what, I'm not going to use the corral... Coral Lariat. Let's sell that. And unfortunately, selling things does not give you points. Which is unfortunate. Gauntlet, please. Not the piano wire. We're not using Geppetto in this playthrough RPG. Well, we're not using him as much as we could. I have a decent amount of money left over. Do I need Leonardo's bears? I have one, but do I need more for the... I might. I can't actually afford any, unfortunately. No armor, really. Well, that would be nice, but... Actually, yeah, I can afford one. Why not? And 80 points. I could probably, you know, selling things, and I could probably get the next rank, but... Let's save that for later. And yeah, the Judgment Ring's very odd with the vending machine. It's just, it's kind of strange. I mean, it's not like it takes one thing that bothers me, that you can... use credit cards and vending machines now. Which, I don't know about you, but I find that incredibly dangerous, not only for, you know, my bank account, but also my waistline. I mean... Although the one at work, for some reason, you know, most vending machines, you can... A lot of the stuff in it is some denomination of your local whatever currency, like for me, things are a dollar. For some reason, a lot of the stuff at work now is like $1.10. Like... I don't know, that just seems... Like, it's the whole argument, if you are selling hot dogs, for example, or hamburgers, or something, and you're making 25 cents, like 10 cents on each one, let's say, and you're selling 50, then you up it so you're making 25 cents and you sell 5, I don't know, I think it might be a case of that. I'm sure that they had someone figure that out, though. Anyway, why am I talking about vending machines? I mean, we went from using the Judgment Ring to acquire goods at a cheaper price at a game vending machine to talking about real ones. Anyway, the Neem Ruins. This place is a welcome change considering the places that we have been. Faceguard, which, yes please. Actually, didn't I? I bought one, didn't I? Yeah, we can get rid of that. Let's get rid of that. The Neem Ruins is... Actually, should I use a tent? I have 19. Well, I could go back... Nah, it's fine. I should have enough supplies. This place is... quite a bit larger than the last few places we've been. Hence, you know, the nice change. I mean... short dungeons are nice and all, but if you just, you know, you need a little bit of variety is what I'm trying to say. I mean, I don't want them all to be super long dungeons, but you know, it gets to a point where, yeah. Yeah. So... unfortunately, even though this place is a nice change, it's a lot larger than the places we've been recently. Enemy variety, on the other hand, doesn't really support it. Like, you face a lot of the same enemies for basically the whole thing, but, I think there's only 3 enemy types. It'd be nice if you went down, like, 2 floors and found, you know, a new set of enemies. But we don't have that luxury. It goes back to the whole variety thing, you know what I mean? So it's nice we have a, you know, longer dungeon. It's bad that the dungeon doesn't have great enemy choices. One thing that I do need to do in the near future, as soon as I get another attack boost, I think I'm just going to give it to Lucia. Not because she does a fantastic amount of damage, but in case she misses with her one attack, she won't break her combo. Especially if she goes first. I think Offnir here is mostly status ailments, I want to say. I don't actually entirely remember. No damage victory, which is nice, but that's not going to be the case for the foreseeable future. Usually, this place has mostly large enemies. Again, there's only 3. 2 large enemies and 1 small enemy that come in very large groups. Oh. Oh. Horrible things happening. Well, this is Shadow Hearts. I mean, that's pretty much par for the course, isn't it? I mean, really. This place does have... it's more puzzle-oriented. I mean, there is a ton of combat because, well, you're going to be going all over the place. But... it's more of a puzzle dungeon, really. Which, again, is nice since, well, the last one was kind of puzzles, but that was just, you know, bring this thing here and flip this switch, and it wasn't really that bad. This place is a little bit more complicated than that, and we're going to be here a while. This place is not small in the slightest. Oh, that one heads back. The one to the left. You can go back to the entrance, which I don't really want to do. Not currently, at least. Talisman of Luck, yes please. Actually, RPG, weren't you supposed to buy those? That should be fine. I don't think we actually need them. Of course, now, you know, everybody dies horribly. Did we ever look at anything from the last area? Yeah, and Janus is indeed light-based. Which is still a little bit odd, considering, you know, its aesthetics. But then again, go to the previous game and we've had, I think it was a water-based one that looked fire, or vice versa, or something like that. The game likes to throw you a curveball. It's not entirely everything is obvious, la-di-da-di-da. Which is fine, but in some cases, it's like, really? Thankfully, I think it's pretty much reserved to, bosses. Karen leveled in that fight, which is nice. How are we doing on affinity, especially with Lucia, since, well, not very good. Yeah, Blanca's almost at 50. With Yuri, at least. We're doing alright. I don't really need to pay attention to it until, you know, we get to the point where people start maxing out. Although, to be fair, later in the game, I probably won't care who's working with who. I mean, that will become a thing. Theraseed, why not? I don't think that actually helps me any. Really? Did I just screw myself? I don't remember how to do this dungeon. That's awkward, especially since you've already played through an RPG. I'm not talking like, you know, 10 years ago. Actually, no, what was it, like 7? I'm talking like last week. So that's kind of bad. What am I? I don't think I want to. I might want to go this way. There's a button, but I'm not sure if I want to press it or not. Well, I kind of have to. Otherwise, I'll be stuck here forever. There's one of the other. Actually, they're both at other enemies. That's nice. Anyway, you're pretty much always using Sorm at this point. Just because it's really convenient. Unfortunately, unlike in the last game, you don't really have the opportunity to change where people are, which is kind of a down thing. Othian and the Calamity Orbs. I've seen them come, the Calamity Orbs, come in groups of 6. Like, they travel in packs. I think he casts Rage on himself. I think. And this is why I need to get her an attack boost. Oh boy. And the thing is usually when someone hits something, you don't normally miss afterwards, so that was some pretty bad luck. Well, with Lucia, well, special attack down. Oh, Blanca's dead. Oops. Should probably have healed him, considering, you know, the fact that he just went through a wolf bout RPG. Yeah, that probably would have been a good idea. This is another reason why I don't like Lucia off the bat, because I've pretty much already given out my attack boosts. And being in situations like this, if she misses, I'm pretty much boned. Yeah, they don't have as much life as the Ofnirs, the snake things, which is a little bit odd in my opinion. Could be bad, especially with Heaven. And unfortunately, Lucia's dark-based. I should probably heal Lucio. Actually, Crest Magic. Then again, Lucia has Arc Cure. Well, Blanca can heal Blanca. That last one felt like a gift. Yeah, they don't have a lot of life, but it's their numbers that I'm concerned about. No. Do I want to risk a tarot card? Why not? This is gonna be bad, isn't it? Thanks, glitches! Oh! That's not terrible? I mean, SP would be... I've got two enemies left. Yeah, I need to kill them quick. So that could have gone much better. But hey, you know what? I've got to risk something eventually. Even though it's like, stay away from tarot cards, they're terrible RPG. At the same time, I still need to try them. Lucia's just gonna miss? Oh no. Yeah, she hits reasonably hard. And 500 in cash, so the money's good here. I mean, at least that's in our favor. Yeah, I hadn't pushed the button yet. I was just thinking because it was like, have I pushed a button? No, I got in combat as soon as the, camera angle changed. Can I get to where I actually want to be? Oh, boy. Actually, this is the way we came in, isn't it? Is it? No, it's not. It's the way down. Why did I... Is there something I missed in the previous floor? I feel like there's an area that I haven't been to yet. Too bad you can't, you know, swing the camera around. But it's fine. Because I feel like I haven't been in the northwest corner, and I want to be. No, actually, I think we're alright. So this is a waste of time, that's fine, though. And hey, if I get in none of the combat that hands over 500 cash... It's not exactly a bad thing. Well, I've wasted your time, I've wasted mine, it's fine. At least now I don't have the niggling feeling in the back of my mind that goes, hey RPG, you missed stuff. Not really a fan of that. Oh, I remember this room. It's not that bad, really. I wonder how the game decides what combo magic I'm getting. Because there's three that I still have yet to even be able to use, but I keep getting the four that I've already used. I wonder why. I wonder how it determines it. It might be, you know, this character gets these four, and this character gets these four, and I just haven't combo magicked on the characters that have it. I don't know. Also kind of wonder how the, points are decided as far as, as the buying and selling rings are. Like, when you buy stuff, how is it determined how many points you get? You know what I mean? Hopefully I'm doing this right. Hopefully. And this is what I'm talking about. Not only that, but two of them start in combo. That's less than good. Really? Five-person combo. It does happen. Wow. Okay, then. You know, I went from Sorm to Lucia to Sorm. Do they get 2 points now? 2 affinity points? I would think so. Lucia leveled, and... which way am I going? I could have sworn I hit the right key? The right button, the circle button for that combo? But it said combo break, so 5-person is either not a thing, or I didn't quite make the button press in time. It's one of the two. I have no idea which, and it's going to be a really long time before I can try that again, because that's just not something that happens all the time. That's a rarity. Maybe someone who knows this game a whole lot better than I do can answer that question, but I currently cannot. Let's not. That's a little bit on the expensive side, especially when we have Blanca, who only needs 3 MP to heal. That, and I can heal Blanca, which, you know, I neglected to do after his wolf bout, which is rather negligent, but it's fine. He'll be fine. And a save point! I'm a little bit short of actually power- well, I can't really do anything in the graveyard anyway. Next time, more of the Neem Ruins. And here we are in a dungeon. No, don't load RPG. Here we are in a dungeon that's going to take more than one video to go through. I'm like the last two. Until then, Neem Ruins / Floating Maze. Well, that last one is very accurate, isn't it? Until next time.